we saw each other in LA when you were doing, I was doing ADR and you were doing some like green screen shit.
Oh, really?
Remember that?
Not really.
Okay.
Oh, it's been a long time, man. It's been a long time,
right? Well, the movie, yeah, 30 years, like in July is when we were filming it.
Yeah. In
beautiful Montreal.
Yeah, it was beautiful out there. Oh,
it was gorgeous.
It was really, it was, I do remember that. I remember that, man. But yeah, we ran into each other at the airport.
Yep.
You know, and yeah, man.
We're both frankly shocked that Brainscan has held up this well. Or actually, no, not shocked, but like...
I am.
Are you?
I am, dude. You know what, like...
I'm surprised that you people have such good taste, mm-hmm. you know, because like I saw it in the theater, so I'm like, this is great, but it didn't do well. Then it came on cable, and now like people appreciate what a brilliant job we all did. So I give you all credit for having such good taste.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it was crazy. It didn't do well at all. We were talking about that. It's like, you know, it bombed, really.
It kind of did.
And it's just weird to show you, like, how some movies, man, they just have legs on them. And, yeah, people, I mean, don't people come up to you all the time?
No.
Really?
I don't look like Kyle. Do you? They come up to you all, they know you.
I get that a lot, man. Yeah. You know? Yeah, like conventions and all that, you know, because you're there anyway. So,
yeah.
I mean, I don't look like I did back then either.
Yeah, well, Andrew Kevin Walker, who wrote it, I saw him in like a thing he did for the DVD, and he was like, you know, sometimes people will come up to me like, Andrew Kevin Walker, oh my God, I'm such a fan. You, and he's like, yeah, Seven. He's like, no, Brainscan. And he was like, wow, thank you. So even he gets that.
Yeah.
It's great.
Yeah.
So, can you tell us some like on-set stories, like what, you know, anything interesting?
Shit, dude. You know, I mean, honestly, again, I was 16, and it's been 30 years, so it's kind of, my memory's not too great on it, so I it's a little hard for me to pick out exact little things. I mean, Jamie might be able to do it better.
Well, than me, like. I mean, if you want to know, I did have a little bit of a fling with Jean-Michel Petier, who played my sort of girlfriend. And the guy, the wonderful Canadian actor who played the teacher in the horror class where we were showing Death, 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 him and I actually went out and got super drunk at this by the bar in Montreal. I had like a I saw him in the hotel lobby. He's like, yeah, I was thinking about going and getting a drink. I'm like, I have some vodka upstairs. So we went upstairs, finished the bottle of vodka, and then went out. So Kyle and that teacher hung out. He was a great guy. I found out he's died recently. Hats off to him. Well, I can't remember his name, but he was nothing like the teacher.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, I was like 15, so I was still a semi-good kid. I didn't really go out and party that much yet, but yeah, man, you know.
Well, you were the youngest on set, right? So how did that feel of being around older people?
It was great. I mean, that's kind
of. But he was the star, so it's not like, you know, he was like feeling like, oh, I'm a little kid. It's like, what does Eddie want? You know?
Yeah. I mean, pretty much. Yeah, it's usually if you're a main actor in the movie.
Yeah.
People treat you pretty nice.
He'd literally just come off T2, so it was. I mean, that was how the movie probably got made and shit. You know?
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, I remember it was a good time, man.
I saw a deleted scene. I don't know if you guys ever saw it. In between where you, in the end scene with you and Amy, Amy, the love interest, they actually have a deleted scene on YouTube where Trickster and your character were like these. It was like a puppet thing. It was like really weird. Like comes up and like. Have you seen that?
I know what you're talking about. Okay. That thing got cut out because it was too gross.
Yeah. It was interesting. Between at the end scene, there was like.
I don't know. Wait, what? It was cut. What?
There was this weird like. Puppet, this weird little freaky little Muppet that came over the bed, and Amy was screaming like, "Ah, get away from me!" Ah. I mean, Amy, whatever character, and they decided they didn't put that in the end movie. Probably could.
Yeah.
There was also in the script, his character Michael killed Kyle on camera. When you know you find out that he killed, somehow you find out because you find my thing, and the producers and I was really looking forward to shooting that. I kept asking about it. And the producers came up and they're like, listen, we're watching the dailies, and your character is so likable, we've decided we don't want Michael to kill you on camera. Uh-huh. And I mean, sometimes producers will tell you things to, like, you know, make you feel good when they just don't have time to shoot the scene. So I was like, oh, that's terrible, but isn't that great that I'm likable? So, but I still wish I had been... You're
killed. Don't I in the movie think I killed you?
You
something?
Do kill me in the game.
Yeah, in the game. Yeah.
Yeah, you killed
me. That would have been kind of badass, though.
I know.
That would have been kind of badass. I mean, it would have taken it to a much darker
level. It would have just been like a half a day, you know? Yeah, but they didn't want to go to that dark, dark place that you are finding so attractive, killing poor Kyle, who was... I watched it recently, and Kyle was a nice kid. That's what I wanted. I wanted to just be like a really fun best friend.
Yeah.
And you copied.
Oh, yeah. I wanted to be Spicoli because, of course, Sean Penn's a hero of mine, and Spicoli was a great character. But, you know, Kyle didn't smoke weed. Now Kyle could have smoked weed, but back, you know, the thing that made Spicoli so great was because he was always stoned. But Kyle couldn't be always stoned, so I had to just be fun and nice.
In Brainscan, you played like a 15-year-old, and what were you, like 27 at the time?
I was 26. What are you saying? Where are we going with this? What do I
no,
like?
No, I'm just saying you still look young. Nobody would believe this guy's 90 now.
Yeah, I know, exactly. Yeah, I know. I've always looked young, and I played younger characters, and it worked out for me. Yeah, Eddie was 15, and I was playing his best friend. Yeah.
Have you guys kept in touch?
Not at all.
Not at all.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But when
are
we
you
saw
living
each
in
other,
LA?
Yeah, we both live in LA. When we saw each other, it was like, you know, no time had passed. Yeah. And he's, you know, he was a great kid then, and you know, he's
we'll
a good guy.
Yeah.
Yeah, we actually were
now
gonna.
You
we're,
will.
We're,
yeah,
we're
yeah. You'll reconnect
yeah.
now.
It's funny actually, because this all happened really last minute because Scott pulled this all together very last minute, and man, it's exciting, man. You know,
it
like
is
whatever.
Exciting.
It's
How
running
do you
into
like being in Suffolk County. New York in the middle of the winter.
It's freezing, babe.
It reminds me of my childhood in Bedford Hills.
That's Westchester, right?
That is in Westchester, but you know, Bedford Hills. So
tell us something about your character in the Forest Hills and the name of your character, if you know it.
You know, I could just make it all up because it's not that well established. I'm his friend, and I am just one of his henchmen, basically. Yeah. So I could build a big backstory, but you know. It's I don't know. He's a really horrible person, and he's got, you know, a personality disorder, and you know, we'll just go with that.
I know, but don't you think that this movie is really unique because it's bringing together so many people from way back when? Isn't that terrific?
Because they're the only ones that'll do it.
it's almost prophetic. It's almost,
I'm quite amazed that the Brainscan Instagram page is as popular as it is, and Brainscan has become like a cult horror movie from the 90s, starring, you know, because of Eddie, of course. And also the writer, it was a great script, and the director was great, and so people love this movie, and it's like, yeah, great, okay.
Yeah, well now,
especially
now
over the last like 10 years, yeah, it's ramping
tell
up.
Tell everybody
ramping
out
up,
there yeah. that yeah. about Brainscan. Over the last 10 years, it's really become even more popular. But now everybody's going to look at The Forest Hills, right?
The Forest Hills,
yeah.
Well, Brainscan's about like a kid who like plays video games and is really sullen and, you know, is sort of a loner and an outsider. So I think that, you know, today's society can relate to it a lot more. You know, sort of isolating and...
Yeah, that was almost ahead of its time,
and,
right?
Dude, honestly, it's funny too because we were kind of talking about this. The room that my character has in Brainscan is like every kid's dream.
Yeah.
Even today.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't think we have computers that talk and shit like that, really, like that one, you know. So, it's pretty cool, dude. Like, I remember so many people would come up and been like, dude, I was so jealous he had, like, all
well,
that.
Well, the idea of Brainscan, you know? Wasn't it that what you were playing on your video game, you actually came to be, you thought,
it was a
right?
CD-ROM video game, which was what was really cutting edge back then. And this character comes out of the video game, and it somehow it makes a trance. I don't want to, you know, spoiler alert. It makes like some trance effect that makes him think that what's going on is real. But we really have to give credit to this guy. T. Rider Smith. Sorry, T. Rider, who played the trickster, who is brilliant, who just jumps off the screen at you. Yeah. So he really was the secret.
Thank you, guys. Bye. Have a good trip back to L.A.